Hello and welcome again to channel 48 on this beautiful, beautiful
Friday morning effect.
I just made a little snapshot of the sky above me at this moment of recording this video, and you can see there's even a little planet showing up here, a little blue planet. It's always there when I make a picture. So I'm very happy to have that little blue planet with me there, you know. So yesterday I showed you and spoke about the Samsung Galaxy S6, and I showed you effect the ROM that was created by lostlegacy.da, Linux OS 17, and I as well showed you the S4 ROM for the i9505. I did get a comment from somebody telling me, I think it was DarkX, not sure, and he asked me if I ever heard of the Evolution X ROM. And in fact, yes, I did, of course, the one from Lucas Berger, you know, for the S8, the GSI. But in fact, I did not follow if there was actually really even more development going on than, in fact, the NS Sosun ROM, the 9 that was updated to 10 and got a second build. We showed them all. Effect, and of course EROMs as well supporting the S6. I baked a ROM that I'm as well gonna show today, together with the Evolution X4 ROM that was by Lunarixus. So Lunarixus, yeah, yesterday I said, you know, two people are working on, at least three, including E, but you know, NS Sosun and Lost Legacy, but I failed to find your development, so sorry for that. So Lunarixus, this video is as well for you, and will show your first build of effect Evolution X that was released on the 22nd of March.
Okay, there we are with the Evolution ROM. What we're gonna do is a quick wipe, and we're just gonna wipe the phone, and we're gonna go ahead and install Evolution 4.x. There it is, and we're gonna install it really fast. Here you can as well, if you take a closer look, see the guys that worked on this ROM. So this was a big group of people. I saw many names, as well as Tricktet. I saw Lucas Berger. So some family of mine is as well, you know, credited by Lunarixus for the, yeah, for this ROM, for it existing. So I'm very happy about that. So that gives a good feeling when we see certain names as well in the project. So yeah. Some guys, they just have that special touch, yeah, on ROMs. And when you install their ROMs, then in fact you immediately like the work, and immediately, you know, are kind of open to the work, and then desperately waiting for the next ROM to pop up. And there we are booting up. And Lucas B and Stricted, these are two of these kinds of people. Their ROMs are always nice, and sometimes not everything works out of the box yet, but you know, these guys are busy doing all sorts of things. And there we are. And this is the Google setup. As you already could understand, in this ROM you will find Google services installed, and that will immediately give you access to all your accounts, and you will be able to use this ROM out of the box already. So I'm gonna set it up really fast, and there we are. It's a lovely ROM. As you can see, we have the most basic applications already installed. And this is Android 10 by Evolution X with the security patches of March 2020. And there we go, Android 10, Android Q, lovely for the Samsung Galaxy S6. So is everything working in this ROM? Well, that is something that we shall find out, that we still must find out. I can say that there is a red line at the boot up of the phone, and that is kinda, yeah, saying that kernel is not enforcing SE Android something, not enforcing, something like that. I have no idea what that means. I must still look it up. The camera is recording with a green screen. So yeah, if you want a perfect green screen, you can use the selfie to create a nice green screen background video without you in it. So yeah, the cam is not perfect yet. We can see if we can fix that. I do have a mod, and it has open camera as well in it. Let's see if we're gonna go to the recovery. Yes, and let's go ahead and install it. It's called my Pug mod. It's boot animation friendly, this one, so it will not replace the boot animation. But here you can see the red line. And I don't know what happened now. Okay, we got into a black screen. What we're gonna do is hold down volume and power until we see that the logo pops up again. Keep holding, and there it is again. And we're just gonna let it boot and see if now it will boot. Okay, it's booting again. So you must not panic when these things happen, okay? If the thing is not immediately booting up the way it should, it goes into a black screen and you don't know what's crack-a-lacking. Just hold down the volume power, the volume and the power, volume down and power, and then it should boot up again. Okay, so don't get scared. And let's see if my applications are there. Yes, they are all there. You see that all my applications are in one go installed into the ROM, and they will be there even if I'm gonna do a factory data reset. They will all come back. So the cam, yeah, the cam has a problem, guys. It's not working, not even the open camera is as well failing on me there. So yeah, what can I say? The camera should be fixed still. You see that? It's as well stocking up with... No, it's not working. Jammer, unfortunately. Could not connect to camera. Nou ja, that is a pity, because there's a very good camera in this phone. But don't forget, this is the first ROM of Lunarexus, guys. So let's not start with complaining about the things that don't work. I'm just letting you know that the camera is not working yet. And maybe if you're gonna use Futai camera, suddenly the thing works. Or maybe G-Cam, I don't know. Or maybe even, probably G-Camera is already installed. It is a very advanced camera, but unfortunately, inota trabajo, you know, it's not working. So yeah, for me, this ROM, yeah, is very nice. I like it, but it's just not good enough yet. So I'm gonna show you the second ROM, and the second ROM, that is my EROM. Cooked Windows phone. Okay, and there it is. You can see it there. Windows phone. For this phone, for this model, yes, it's the right file pack. Let's flash it. And here you can see Windows Phone by PugROM, ROM officially developed by eFoundation, and it's untouched. Here we're flashing root. Root is pushed into the ROM, so you will be rooted out of the box, but root will only work after a reboot, okay? So when you go into the system, when we're gonna boot into the system now, root will not function yet, but it will function after another reboot, okay? That's just how it is. So don't expect root to work yet. It will work after a reboot. Don't forget about that, okay? This ROM you can download from my Android file host. I will put the link up there for you, for those that did not test it yet or want to test it. And I think Johannes has this phone as well. Not sure if Johannes already has this ROM, because I did create some ROMs, WP phone, at least WP, Windows phone ROMs, Android themed ROMs, powered by E in this case. E is the engine, you know, that's the engine of my BMW that I'm showing you here. And I'm very happy about it. And there you go. Boom. And this is our launcher, powered by Square Launcher, a very, very nice company that does not put ads and crazy things into the launcher. They believe that a launcher should not have these kinds of things. So thumbs up to them. Up here you can buy a license key. You will need to install the Google Play Store for that. So do it on another device where you have that all installed. Or you can as well do it from here, because we have Micro G as well built into the system. So all your applications that require Google services to be installed, they will work. Okay, so that is, I think, a very fantastic thing. Oh, I missed it there. And in fact, yeah, what I'm doing now, I'm just rebooting to see if Magisk will work, because I as well want to kind of team here. You can see the name of the phone, but as well the security patches. These are still from February 2020. So yeah, I think that the new build will or is already out with the March security patches. Link will as well be to the official original EROM for this phone. Okay, the unmodded one. So you will have two links, one to my modded version that you can download from my Android file host, and one that goes to the eFoundation devices page, where you will as well find ROMs for your device if you're supported in these 92 devices that they are, you know, covering. And then you can see root is now working. See that? So now super user is available, and now we can turn on things like firewall and, you know, all these applications that need root, such as the file browser. And these are the applications, good applications that I use for many years already. And I'm kind of happy to see that they all run very nice on the EROM. Even more cool is that, of course, the EROM is updating their firmware every 2 weeks. There's a new nightly coming out. These guys are a daughter from Lineage OS, and the official ROM that these guys create, in fact, have the looks of a modern iOS phone. We as well have Magisk Magic Earth built in. I said Magisk, I meant Magic Earth, apologies for that. And of course, a great music player. We have NPO that will finally work thanks to the Micro G built in. Amazing. And I see that I had to remove my open camera package out of the ROM. So we have two open cameras. Use the one with the dark icon. That's the official one that comes with this ROM. These guys are as well, you know, using open camera. They as well believe that open camera is the best camera to use in any Android phone, thanks to all these extra settings that it has, you know, that will as well let older phones make a nice decent recording. And this all is working nice, I must say. Camera looks good, nice and bright, lovely. We have Firefox and the RXTX radio player, there it is. Yeah, as well a nice radio for amateurs and these guys that love broadcasting and listening to police scanners and things like that. You can set the theme nice to black. We have World Radio Droid as well, of amazing application that will let you listen to radio stations all over the world. We have a root firewall, there it is, the ultra firewall, and this is the scanner radio. It will let you browse for your favorite streams. And of course the root firewall, the ultra firewall, that is I think the most beautiful thing. It will ask for root permission, allow it root permission, and go ahead and block the application that you want to block. Most of the times I block things like gallery, I think a gallery notes, they don't have to go on the internet. You know, if I put a note, it should not be connected to some port that, you know, somebody could get to that note. Because, these applications, they are all connected via some port to the internet. So, in fact, that means that they are all accessible via the internet. One and one is two. Can never be three, right? So, you must be as well cautious and check out the applications that you install. Don't install just every application. Don't think that it cannot harm your system. Really, it can harm your system. You know, certain applications, you must stay 1.5 meters from them away. Otherwise, you know, you might get a phone that will get sick. If you understand what I'm saying, you don't want your phone to get some virus. You as well have Bitdefender is built in. The moment you're gonna do a scan, it will, you know, run on the background and scan each and every incoming or outgoing file. Well, most of the times incoming files of your system, and it will make sure that you're not gonna get some malware on your on your phone. As we all know, Bitdefender is a trusted virus scanner. Big companies are as well working with Bitdefender, and it's just amazing to have a great phone in return. So go ahead, check out the Android 10 ROM from Lunarexis, or go for this beautiful EROM.
Yes, so that was the two nice ROMs, Evolution X4, and of course my baked version of the EROM. I want to thank you for watching. I hope you think this was a cool video. And I'm sure that many of you will love the Evolution ROM just because it has Google services built in. The EROM, as well, if you want to see a nice ROM that is kind of iOS modeled, it's a beautiful ROM, check out EROM. It's out there for, I think,
92 phones.
Okay, all sorts of models, link will be in the description, or just Google E space ROM and you will find the first founding in Google. That will bring you to the E Foundation, where you can as well find official development for your device. Most of the times not on the highest ROMs, not always Android 9 or 8 or it starts with 7, in fact, and 7 is still fine if it's being updated on regular base, and you know, then there's nothing wrong with 7. This Samsung Galaxy S6 is one of a kind. It's a beautiful device. It had to wait very long for development to come its way, but now it's there, and now we can happily say we can still use our Samsung Galaxy S6 proudly, even in 2020.